Hello friends. So we have done conditionals 0, 1st, 2nd and 3rd. Now we have another very interesting point or topic we can say in English grammar, that is no sooner, as soon as, no sooner, scarcely, as soon as, comma, no sooner than, hardly when. Scarcely when. You can express the same idea in four different ways. That's what we are going to do now. Now you see here what I have written. You go through this example, then you can do what is given in the text. As soon as the teacher ended, past tense, simple past. Ended the class, comma. So you begin the sentence with the as soon as. When that as soon as close, at the end of it, close means sentence, you put a comma. Then continue, the students greeted her. Now the question here is, there are two actions in the past. Which one takes place first? The as soon as action takes place first. Let me this clear. We have two actions in the past. We have studied somewhere where. You remember when we did past perfect tense? The first action should be in the past perfect tense and the second should be in the simple past. Isn't it? So, now here the same thing. When you start with as soon as, the sentence is positive. The same sentence can be rewritten in the negative without changing the meaning. Sometimes you will get a question like this. As soon as I saw him, I saluted him. Rewrite in the negative without changing the meaning. Then what will you do? You can start with it, no sooner. Same meaning. But when you start with no sooner, it is negative. Another point to note is that when you start with no sooner, no comma is required. As soon as, comma is there. No sooner, no comma. But then there is a point to remember, that is, as soon as, see the thing, as soon as the teacher entered. Now when you come here, the second one, no sooner had the teacher entered the class than. So no sooner you start, it is negative. Immediately after the negative, there should be an auxiliary verb. That's why no sooner had. As soon as ended. But when you use no sooner, what you do is, you use the past perfect form of that. That is had. Had ended. And had is an auxiliary. So, when you start the sentence with no sooner, immediately after the no sooner, there should be an auxiliary. So, the possible auxiliary, there are two possibilities. One is did. The first possibility, first option is, convert the past tense into a past perfect by had. And then put had just before the subject or immediately after the no sooner. So we can say no sooner had the teacher. See, the teacher is the subject. And so no sooner had the teacher ended. In this case, ended becomes past participle. Because you know, the past perfect is had plus past participle of the given verb. Had gone. When is past tense, but had gone is past perfect. Ate is past tense, but had eaten is past perfect. So in this case, it is same spelling, but This is the past perfect form of ended. Ended. So no sooner had the teacher ended. Now here in this second sentence, ended is past participle. Had the teacher ended the class, then. There is no comma. Instead then, no sooner than. Then the students greeted her. Now, the next possibility is, you can insert do. And since it is past tense, did. So what you do is, no sooner did the teacher enter. Because did enter is equal to ended. When is equal to did go. Ate is equal to did eat. Sang is equal to did sing. So here, because we need an auxiliary. Immediately after no sooner. Therefore, what we do is, no sooner did the teacher enter the class than the students greeted her. So both possibilities are there. The point note is, when you begin a sentence with a negative, it should be immediately followed by an auxiliary. Or an auxiliary should be put before the subject of the sentence. Subject of the sentence is the teacher. But as soon as no problem. As soon as the teacher ended, okay, that's okay. But when you say no sooner, immediately after that there should be an auxiliary. Two possibilities are there. One may convert into a past perfect, you get an auxiliary had. The other is you insert did, do. Do means past tense, do will become did. These things we have discussed in the when we were doing the English tenses. I humbly request you to go through those lessons. Then you will become thorough about this. Alright. And here you have got, you have what you are. Okay. So no sooner than. As soon as, comma. See, that's where the summary one. As soon as, comma. No sooner than. It has the same meaning can be expressed by. The same meaning can be expressed by. No, we can say scarcely. And in that case, instead of then, you should have when. What's the point? So you can see, scarcely had the teacher ended the class when, not then. See, when the students greeted her. Same thing can be expressed by hardly had, because hardly and scarcely both are negatives. So hardly had the teacher ended, past perfect, ended the class, no comma, when the students greeted her. Now look at your textbook. So you can see the exercise, the first sentence is, as soon as I reached the station, the train left. You have got four possibilities. What are the possibilities? First one is no sooner with past perfect. No sooner than. Second is no sooner with the simple past. Did. Than. Third is scarcely when. Fourth is hardly when. I will read out slowly. First question is, first sentence is, as soon as I reached the station, the train left. No sooner had I reached the station than the train left. No sooner did I reach, not reached, but reach the station, the train left. Hardly had I reached the station when the train left. scarcely had I reached past perfect the station when the train left. The second one is, no sooner had we heard the sound than we rushed to the spot. Use asunas. As soon as we heard the sound, comma, we rushed to the spot. No then. Scarcely. Scarcely had we heard the sound when we rushed to the spot. Hardly. Hardly had we heard the sound when we rushed to the spot. Next one is, no sooner did she finish the project than she started a new one. Okay? As soon as she finished the project, she started a new one. As soon as she finished the project, comma, she started a new one. Scarcely, scarcely had she finished the project when she started a new one. Hardly, hardly had she finished the project when she started a new one. Clear. The next one. Hardly had I reached the station when the train left. I think we have done it, isn't it? Station, etc. We have done. So this is what you have to remember. Since summary I have given here, you can see. As soon as, comma, no sooner than, hardly, when, scarcely, when. Immediately after the no sooner, hardly, scarcely, there should be an auxiliary. And the best way to do is convert the past tense of the as soon as clause into a past perfect. Then you can get an auxiliary that you use between no sooner and the subject, hardly and the subject, scarcely and the subject. If it is no sooner, then than. If it is hardly and scarcely, when. I think now that is clear. We have come to the end of part one of your course. Now, from tomorrow or in the near future, we will start with the part two of your course, SSLC English, the scholarship jacket. The scholarship jacket that we will do in the next class. Till then, bye. But in the meanwhile, I will ask you pardon for the disturbance caused by someone by the ringing of the mobile phone. Please delete that. That is enough, I think. Okay? So, till we meet again, bye. Have a nice time. Take things easy. You can go through my grammar classes. There were 449-50 around classes. One section is called school grammar. And then the other section is English grammar tutorials. English grammar tutorials, English grammar school is one. There you don't have exercises, you have only explanations. But in English grammar tutorials, you have explanations plus plenty of exercises. So if you have time, you should devote your time for learning this skill, which is a life skill. Okay, I think that you will do it. So, bye.